First day of school was last week. First football game in school history was tonight.
They stepped onto the field for the first time, and NBC2's Sean Barry was there for the school's first game.
It was just a year ago when, in its first year of history, the Bonita Springs football team was getting dressed in portable locker rooms and practicing at a sterile high school up the road. They had no stadium to call home until tonight. They're young, hungry, and at long last, they are home.
We had the opportunity last year to have to play at other stadiums and call it our home field. This was our house tonight. We got to break ground.
Thursday, the Bonita Springs Bull Sharks, which in just their second season are still competing as freshman and junior varsity teams, christened a brand new stadium on their campus.
Enjoy the game.
Feels amazing. Finally having a facility here at Bonita Springs, brand new. Everything's fresh and clean. When I woke up, I felt like we were just finally going to be at home, not playing on other fields, our home field.
The game against the Palmetto Ridge JV team even came complete.
Good luck, guys.
With a coin toss from Bonita Springs Mayor Peter Simmons.
There's been a lot of people that have waited a number of years for this day, and we're very, very excited.
Look at this. This is what it's all about, and Bonita Springs is on the high school map. We're on the gridiron now, too.
But tonight, a town and a team got a taste of what life will be like one day under the Friday night lights.
It felt amazing. And just like seeing that the city supports us to win games, that's all we want to do.
I mean, you just know the community support. Bonita Springs has been dying for high school. You know, football's the tail that wags the dog in this state, and we finally have a team in Bonita. You know, I'm proud to represent it and be the head of it.
An opening night and loss might not have been what the Bull Sharks wanted, but next year at this time, their opening kickoff won't be on a Thursday night. It will be under the Friday night lights for the first time as a varsity football team. Reporting in Bonita Springs, Sean Barry, NBC2.